Hey everyone, and welcome to the Mark 10 Mission Little Liturgies. I'm so glad you are here to spend time with Jesus. Today, we have a green ordinary time cloth on our prayer table. And as we light our candle, we remind ourselves that Jesus, the light of the world, is with us now. In the gospel we are about to hear, Jesus makes us a wonderful promise. But before that, we need to take a look inside the Mark 10 bag to see if there are any objects for our prayer table. In the Mark 10 bag, we have some praying hands, and we have a picture of Pope Francis. It's time to listen to the words of Jesus. This is a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus be in my thoughts, in my words, and in my heart. If your brother sins against you, go to him and show him his fault, but do it privately, just between yourselves. If he listens to you, you have won your brother back. But if he will not listen to you, take one or two other persons with you, so that every accusation may be upheld by the testimony of two or more witnesses, as the scripture says. And I tell you more, whenever two of you on earth agree about anything you pray for, it will be done for you by my Father in heaven. For where two or three come together in my name, I am there with them. Where two or three come together in my name, I am there with them. What a wonderful promise Jesus makes us today. We can always trust Jesus, and he always keeps his promises. So that means that as we gather together now to spend time with Jesus, we can know in our hearts that he is here with us. We might not be able to see Jesus with our eyes, but he is close to us in our hearts. And there is a beautiful way that we can be with him every day. It's called prayer. In your school, each day and in every classroom, children stop to pray. What a marvellous gift that in the place you come to learn and grow, you can also spend time with Jesus, who loves you so much. Prayer is an amazing gift. But how do we pray? Today, with the help of Pope Francis, I have a few things to help you. The best way to start prayer is by being still. Even when there are other people near you, if you sit comfortably and quiet, you can quickly become calm and ready to pray. I like to close my eyes too, and as I do, I remind myself, Jesus is here. When we pray, we meet with Jesus in our hearts. There are lots of ways to pray, but the simplest is to have a conversation with him. Jesus loves to hear from you. He is interested in everything. What has happened in your day? What you have done, seen, and how all of it has made you feel. You can ask him questions too, about anything you are unsure of. Remember though, just like when we meet our other friends, it's important to give Jesus a chance to speak too. For this, we must try to be quiet and make some time for silence. Some days, just spending this quiet time with Jesus might be everything you need. However, some days, it's great to ask for Jesus' help. There are so many things to pray for though. Where do we start? Well, Pope Francis has a super easy way to remember who and what we can pray for. He calls it the five-finger prayer. You can use your hand to help you and pray with me now. First, look at your thumb. Your thumb is closest to you, and we begin by praying for those closest to us, our family and loved ones. Thank you, Jesus, for everything they do for us. Bless them and keep them safe. Next is your index finger. This is our pointing finger and is a reminder to pray for all those who teach and guide us. Jesus, thank you for them and help them to show us the right way to go. Our middle finger is the tallest, and here we can pray for our leaders and those who make big decisions for our country and our world. Lord Jesus, please guide them as they make choices that can help everyone. Your fourth finger, this one, is your weakest. It reminds us to pray for those who are sick or weak or have lots of problems in their lives. Lord Jesus, please be close to them. Heal them and help them to know that you are always with them. Last of all, we have our little finger, the smallest one. This finger is the point where we pray for ourselves. When we have prayed for other people, we can ask Jesus for the things that we might need to live our lives well and for him. So that is Pope Francis's five-finger prayer. As you gather together and spend time with Jesus, that might be one that you could use again and again. Let's spend some time with Jesus now as we pray. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us be quiet and still and remind ourselves that Jesus is here. Jesus, thank you for my family and loved ones. Please help them to be happy and know that you love them so much. Thank you for my teachers and everyone who helps me to learn. Help them to guide others on the right path. I pray, Jesus, for all the leaders in the world. Please help them to listen to your voice so that they can make good choices which help everyone. Jesus, please bless the sick, the weak, and those in need. Help them to know that you are always by their side. Jesus, in the quiet and with my eyes closed, I ask you for the things that I need. Thank you, Jesus, for always being with me and listening to my prayers. I make them all in your name. Amen.
Save us, make us your living Lord.
Thank you for joining us today on the Mark 10 Mission Little Liturgies. We hope this has been a chance for you to learn more about prayer and to know that Jesus is always with you when you come together in his name. We will be doing just that once again when we see each other again next time. Until then, goodbye, God bless, and remember, Jesus loves you. Hello! We've hit the road and travelled here to Walsingham and the National Shrine of Our Lady to invite you to take on our Rosary Challenge. The Rosary Challenge is to pray a decade of the Rosary each weekday in October. There'll most likely be 3 weeks of this in school and 1 week to take on the challenge at home on your half-term break. Each time we will begin with a short Bible reading, and holding your beads, you then pray the Our Father, 10 Hail Marys and one Glory Be, counting on the beads as you go. To help you with this, we have videos for every mystery on our website and a record sheet to help you track your progress through the challenge. Taking on the Rosary Challenge will be a wonderful journey, a chance to join as a class in prayer and to walk with Jesus and Our Lady through the standout moments of their lives. Finally, don't forget to keep us updated on your challenge. We'd love to see on Twitter schools joining the challenge. Just tag us at the Mark 10 Mission and we can celebrate everyone across the country taking on the challenge. Man, I'm so excited for what God is going to do through the Rosary Challenge and can't wait to begin.